I love recycling. I like to reuse things. It's a really good challenge for myself, and I learn new things every day. It started with the 7-month dinner. They threw away so many bottles. So that was the first collection, and they came with like shark fin and smelly things. So I wash and I clean. I started with little things and tried to sell, but they would never sell. After all, it's trash. It's made of trash. They think it's like the material is free. Why should I pay so much for it?
I just run through my room, just randomly run through my room. Oh, okay, my iPad cover is cardboard.
There's this box actually. So I made my iPad cover with this box. It's like very much so that now everything I make, everything I use has to be made by me. It's like everybody say, hey, you made this ? It's like, oh no, I bought this. So somehow I'll try to make everything. I started product industrial design in Temasek Polytechnic. That was like 14 or 15 years ago, and which I get my skills to create even more. From the start, it's like tough, and it has never been like a full-time thing for me. First, I did a lot of odd jobs. I tried to add more skills, like I learned pottery, I learned tailoring. And all these things add up to what I am today, and it's very useful skills. But the hula hoop has been used for other purposes. So you have a frame, and then you can start weaving around. Weaving is very good exercise and therapy for the older ones, the elderlies, because they can exercise their hands. And it's repetitive, they like to do it like slowly. So instead of like knitting and stuff like that, which is a bit more complex, this is much easier. This is just a coke container. I found the idea from the internet, so it's really cool. It snaps in like that. Then you can put cotton, you can put sweets, you can put coins. Because of the curve here, you must cut it to this curve, then it will snap in. I didn't do anything, it's just a bottle. Only coke bottle works. And that explains why I have so many coke bottles here. Morning. Now it's like I'm here at this Amokyo 578, and Shelly here and her team, they actually helped me in a lot of projects, like a collection and craft work. So if I need anything, I'll commission them to get things done for me. This place is like very nice, very cozy. Everybody comes really like a community, like a kampong. So they walk past, will ask what they're doing, and when they're doing for an event, they can promote and they can talk about it. And now we are collecting these bottles, so they actually tell everybody to collect this, and we can make into wallets like that.
Okay.
Then I just fix it up. This time I used the bottle to as tongue and groove to fit it in so there is no tying, whereas my hanging lamps, I actually have them tied with cable ties, so the construction is different. I'm just trying different style, so many things. And I talk a bit about my organizing. This is from the previous art festival, like 2 years ago. This one is all my electronics. These are used for Chingay. So when I collect trash, actually I need to categorize and pack nicely. If not, everything will be everywhere. Not that it's very neat now, but yeah. Okay, what else? So when people ask me why am I doing all this rubbish, I say it's probably from my lifestyle. I don't deliberately plan like after I graduate, I'll become like that. But instead, I'm just going with the flow slowly. I start from small projects and I start from my own stuff, like what I wear, what I use, and slowly it becomes like a market for myself. Plastic, so I pack all the plastic things and all the plastic tools. Then when I come home, I'm so tired, I just leave it. Then maybe the next time I'm doing like fabric, so I'll bring all the fabric scissors, I'll bring all the fabric. Then there's another bag. So this one is actually made of our canvas for a wedding gift. It's a bit rugged now, and I have my rubber tire. This is done by Prison. This is my name card. Prison. I taught there quite a few months. So it was like they really love this because the inmates, they are like more rugged, so they like to sew things like that instead of pretty things. But this was really good for them. And in fact, they can do it better than me now. Prison was really amazing for me because there's so many things I cannot bring in. I bring in one scissors. If I don't bring in, I don't bring in. If we lose a needle, nobody gets out of the prison. So it's actually very minimal, and I cannot show them a lot of materials. Like, you know, usually when you do art and craft, you have a lot of things and you can get a lot of ideas. But for them, it was like minimal. minimal to teach the maximum. Little things and try to sell, but they will never sell because things like this people appreciate, but to pay for it they will not. And after all, it's trash, it's made of trash. They think it's like the material is free, why should I pay so much for it? But the effort of cleaning, keeping, choosing, nobody sees it. I cannot say nobody lah, perhaps there are some who really appreciate, but generally lah. So I had a hard time convincing people what I'm doing. I have every year, like, we have gatherings, people ask me, what are you doing? Why don't you start to find a job, do something stable? But I'm lucky that my family doesn't need me to pay for anything. So I can just slowly do what I like and continue my odd jobs for survival. It's for exhibition, so I have to tell a story about myself, about this kopitiam chair. So there were artists that cut it up and make it into like some stylish artwork, but for me, I'll just wrap it. I don't want to waste it, I'll just keep it as it is and I can still use it. Yes. Oh, I have another kopitiam cup here. They said that it's like for auction, but of course nobody buy lah. So this is my memory of pouring coffee onto the dish, like the very Singaporean way. And I have our yellow pages, I have our calendar and cup of coupons, everything that we always use and waste on this. And very colourful, that's what I like. I like colours, I love colours. It's like they every time I do something, they give it back to me. Then so long. Yeah, I try to keep like every, if it's after 5 years, usually I'll just throw it away. And for materials also lah. If I cannot, then I'll just try to dispose it correctly. TV is good for me because I don't have to explain myself so much anymore. When people see me, oh, so you, and I get the recognition after that. I don't have to convince people, hey, you know, I do this, I do that. You know, when I'm on TV, everybody thinks I'm good. That's like, wow, so easy for me. After which, even now the TV program also, I need to learn to understand that on TV, I need to look sweet and pretty and patient. I'm pretty patient actually, I think, because I'm so used to teaching. But I'm not like that, you know. I also swear and I make a lot of noise, I scream, you know. But on TV I have to be very nice, So it's quite tiring. But I learned to understand that a TV role is like that.
再来，你看，不是。
I was taught to do things from my heart, to be true. Sometimes I get confused if my dad correct or not. But just follow your heart, then do it the right way, and slowly it will get better. And sometimes people say, I'm doing like so well, but if you think about it, it has been several years. But I'm very happy I see improvement. Back to doing things from the heart, if you are sincere about everything you do, people will know and they will feel it. People who abuse me or, you know, it's like, it doesn't really matter to me. Like, 不用计较这么多啦。谢谢!
Alright, one more time everybody! Alright, 1, 2, 3!
<笑>我要讲什么我又不会讲你可以讲华语啊是啊我看你做咯看你的 idea 咯做这些手工好玩吗还可以啦<笑>做了你拿来放什么这里可以放满很多钱可以 good idea 我有时间去一点<笑>